Hey, it's Jen. I had a fantastic question come in. Should we take my child to see another ABM practitioner? So they're seeing their local ABM practitioner who they love and their child loves, but she's thinking of taking their child to another practitioner, a more experienced practitioner. So is this a common thing? Is this a good thing? Should we see more than one practitioner, especially if we already love who we already see? The short answer is yes, absolutely. Go take your child to see more than one ABM practitioner. I highly encourage this. I actually often will offer more names in my local area for my own personal ABM clients to go see different practitioners because we are after creating opportunities for your child's brain to learn. To grow and to learn. So we're creating opportunities for your child's brain to grow and learn and create changes. And the more quality information that we're able to give their brains, the more they're going to change. And we all, as practitioners, as parents, have strengths and skills, unique strengths and skills based on our own unique experience. So what one practitioner is really, really fantastic at, another practitioner might be really fantastic in something totally different because of their experience. And a lot of practitioners have children with special needs of their own, and they kind of have like this unique viewpoint on how to support their child to have these fantastic opportunities for learning and growth because they have the experience of their child's unique diagnosis. So my own daughter has a rare genetic disorder, so I actually naturally in my own community seem to attract a lot of kids who have rare genetic disorders. It's kind of interesting, actually. I also work with a lot of kids who have autism, and a lot of teenagers seem to find me. So I find that really quite interesting. Now, I don't have a lot of local clients who have had things like the SPML surgery, which is quite common for kids with cerebral palsy in our community. If you want to know more about that, I can send you to a Facebook group to learn more about SPML procedure. So I don't personally know a lot about that procedure, but I know a lot of other practitioners who have children, their own children, who have gone through that procedure. So I would for sure recommend them to work with any clients of mine that have had that procedure because it's just we're after a learning brain. We're after our kids to have the best opportunity and space and time and space and to grow and to learn. We're after learning brains. And often that happens with more than one practitioner. Variation is key, or is one of the keys. So variation and going really slow and really connecting to your child. So that's kind of what you're looking for with professionals working with your child. Do they connect with your child? Are they being really gentle and respectful of where they're at? And can they add in variation? And that's one thing you can just kind of naturally get by seeing different practitioners. And even I know a lot of practitioners, myself included, actually have workshops or go and visit other practitioners to give groups of classes with kids. So I often hook up with another practitioner set in Asuyas, BC. It's a great place to go traveling and have a little ABM vacation. So there's three of us practitioners that often see one child for that week, and it's just a fantastic learning experience. So there's many, many practitioners in probably most of the major cities in North America that are actually doing this. So just put your feelers out. Ask your local practitioner if there's other practitioners out there. You'd probably be surprised of how receptive they are to working with a different practitioner because of our own unique experiences of what we can bring to the table. So what I am naturally good at might be totally different from another practitioner. So one practitioner might be really good at that soft, subtle, gentle connecting touch, while another practitioner might be really fantastic at super functional movements that will kind of make it flow easier for your child and really super functional. Like it looked more like a moving lesson sort of thing. So, you know, we all have our strengths and skills, and it's super interesting to see what your child connects with in that moment. And it's just about creating the environment for your child to accelerate their learning potential. And you can do that by really high quality variation. And so that's what Seeing Other Practitioners is really all about, is just creating high quality variation of that high quality movement. So hopefully that helps and answers your question. So if you ever have a chance to see another practitioner, jump on it, go see that other practitioner. I love to take my daughter to see different practitioners. I always, as a parent, I always get new ideas from seeing other practitioners. It's amazing how we as parents can fall into our habitual patterns. Even if I'm a practitioner, I still notice that I fall into my own movement habitual patterns with my daughter. So it's always nice to see how other practitioners approach her, how other practitioners connect with her, how other practitioners move with her. It gives me a really good oversight and overview, a different perspective that then I can bring home and add in that rich variation for her to create those opportunities to learn and to grow. So yeah, hopefully that's helpful. Go see other practitioners if you can, and connect with your local practitioner and ask them. They probably have a list of names. There's also practitioners that travel when the restrictions are off. If you're living in an area where there isn't restrictions, often there's a lot of practitioners that will actually travel from town to town. And in this day and age, there's also many of us, probably most of us actually, practitioners offer Zoom classes or Zoom one-on-one calls. So you can get a call, you know, with us one-to-one, where I can see you and you can see me, and we can talk and chat and look at your child and give you lots of tips and tricks that you can use at home and start incorporating some of these slow, gentle movements right at home. So chances are there's practitioners out there in your area that do private Zoom calls. There's practitioners out there that are willing to travel. And there's probably practitioners out there that are already in connection to your local practitioner that they're willing to work with as well. So hopefully that's helpful, and we'll see you in the next video. Okay, bye.